गामा एंड बीटा फंक्शन, दिस इज योर टॉपिक फॉर टुडे एंड वी विल स्टडी कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ दीज टू फंक्शंस. सी द इंटीग्रल फ्रॉम 0 टू 1 एक्स टू द पावर एम माइनस 1 इनटू 1 माइनस एक्स टू द पावर एन माइनस 1 डीएक्स फॉर एम ग्रेटर देन 0 एंड एन ग्रेटर देन 0. दिस इज योर बीटा फंक्शन एंड दिस इज कन्वर्जेंट फॉर दीज टू conditions on m and n. And integration from 0 to infinity x to the power n minus 1 e to the power minus x dx, which is a gamma function, and it is convergent for n greater than 0. We will see them separately. First see convergence of gamma function. The integral from 0 to infinity x to the power n minus 1 e to the power minus x dx is convergent if and only if n is greater than 0. See its proof. Suppose we take fx as x to the power n minus 1 into e to the power x minus x. So it can be written as e to the power minus x divided by x to the power 1 minus n. See, this integral will be proper for n greater than or equal to 1. Because in this case, 1 minus n will be less than or equal to 0. So x will go to the numerator. And therefore, the given integral will be a proper integral. This function, the integrand f, it has infinite discontinuity at x equal to 0 if n is your less than 1. See, if n is less than 1, then 1 minus n will be positive. And in this case, for x at x is equal to 0, the function or the integrand f will have infinite discontinuity. So we need to examine the convergence of f at 2 points, 0 and infinity, both. See, we can write integration from 0 to infinity, x to the power n minus 1, e to the power minus x dx, as integration from 0 to 1, this is your fx dx, plus integration from 1 to infinity, fx dx. So this interval 0 to infinity is divided into two parts, 0 to 1 and 1 to infinity. The first integral is I1 and the second integral is I2. So for I1, we need to check the convergence at 0. And for I2, we need to check the convergence at infinity. So we will do them one by one. First, see convergence at 0 and less than 1. Let us have a function gx given by 1 by x to the power 1 minus n, then fx by gx. Here we will use comparison test. That is why we need to have another function gx, and the ratio fx by gx is equal to e to the power minus x by x to the power 1 minus n multiplied by x to the power 1 minus n. So it is e to the power minus x. Now take limit x tending to 0 fx by gx. It will be limit x tending to 0 e to the power minus x. So its value is 1, non-zero. But integration from 0 to 1 gx dx is equal to integration from 0 to 1 gx dx by x to the power minus n. It converges if this 1 minus n is your less than 1. We have seen its proof earlier. That is, n is greater than 0. Hence, by comparison test, integration from 0 to 1 fx dx will be converging if n is greater than 0 and less than 1. And consequently, this I1 will be convergent if n is greater than 0. So the convergence of I1 at 0 is complete. Now see the convergence at infinity. Let gx is equal to 1 by x square. So fx by gx will be x to the power n minus 1 into e to the power minus x into x square. So this is equal to x to the power n plus 1 by e to the power x. This n minus 1 and 2 both will be added to the power of x. So this is equal to limit x tending to infinity, fx by gx equal to limit x tending to infinity, x to the power n plus 1 by e to the power x. See, this is your infinity by infinity type. So we will apply here L'Hospital rule. So after applying L'Hospital rule, several times we will get its value as 0. for all n. But integration from 1 to infinity gx dx will be integration from 1 to infinity 1 by x square dx. It is convergent because this 2 which is power of x is greater than 1. So this is convergent, and hence by comparison test I2, which is given as this one, it will also be convergent if n is greater than 0. So this integral from 0 to infinity x to the power n minus 1 e to the power minus x dx for n greater than 0, it is called gamma function, and it is convergent. Also, we denote it by this gamma within bracket n. So remember, gamma n is for integral from 0 to infinity x to the power n minus 1 e to the power minus x dx and n greater than 0. Next, we will have convergence of beta function. The integral from 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1 into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx is convergent if and only if m and n both are positive. See its proof. For m greater than or equal to 1 and n greater than or equal to 1, the given integral is a proper integral. See, if m is greater than or equal to 1, so this x will be in the numerator only. And for n greater than or equal to 1, this 1 minus x will be in the numerator only. So the given integral will be proper integral from 0 to 1, for integration from 0 to 1. 0 and 1, these are the only two points of infinite discontinuity when m is less than 1. When m is less than 1, 0 will be your point of infinite discontinuity. And when n is less than 1, this 1 is your point of infinite discontinuity. Now take a number c between this 0 and 1, that is 0 less than c less than 1, then we can write this integral as integration from 0 to c fx dx plus integration from c to 1 fx dx, or it is I1 plus I2. If m is less than 1, 0 is the point of infinite discontinuity of f1 in this I1. So we will check convergence of this I1 at point 0. See, when m is less than 1, let fx is given as x to the power n minus 1 into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1. So it is written as 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 by x to the power 1 minus m. And take gx is equal to 1 upon x to the power 1 minus m. Then fx by gx will be 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 by x to the power 1 minus m into x to the power 1 minus m. These two will cancel each other. So this is equal to 1 minus x to the power n minus 1. Now take limit x tending to 0. Fx by gx, it will be limit x tending to 0, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1. So its value will come out to be 1. You just expand this binomially and take limit as x tending to 0. So you will get here 1, means which is a non-zero finite quantity. But integration from 0 to c gx dx is equal to integration from 0 to c 1 upon x to the power 1 minus m dx is converging if this 1 minus m is less than 1. It means m is greater than 0. Therefore, integration from 0 to c fx dx is equal to integration from 0 to c x to the power m minus 1 into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx converges if m is less than greater than 0, and consequently if m is greater than 0 and less than 1. So I1 is converging for m greater than 0. Next, for I2, convergence at 1. When n is less than 1, if n is less than 1, the point of infinite discontinuity of I2 will be 1. Take fx as x to the power m minus 1 into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1, or x to the power m minus 1 by 1 minus x to the power 1 minus n, and gx as 1 by 1 minus x to the power 1 minus n. Now compute fx by gx. It will be x to the power m minus 1. This is your fx by gx. Take limit x tending to 1 fx by gx. So it will be limit x tending to 1 x to the power m minus 1. So its value will be 1 for x tending to 1. So, but integration from c to 1 gx dx will be integration from c to 1 1 by 1 minus x to the power 1 minus n dx. It is converging if 1 minus n is less than 1. See, we have proved this as a theorem. So that is n is your greater than 0. Sorry. Hence, by comparison test, integration from c to 1 fx dx is equal to integration from c to 1 x to the power I minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx converges if n is greater than 0, and consequently for 0 less than n less than 1. Hence, the given integral 0 to 1 fx dx converges for all positive values of m and n. So this is also proved. This integral for m and greater than 0 is called beta function, and we denote it by d within bracket m comma n. So this is complete for your convergence of gamma function and beta function. After this, we will have next class on some other another day, and that will deal with Abel's test and Dirichlet's test. This will complete your this paper, and from the next day we will start your third paper. If you have any query, you just message me. Also, the lecture will be available on my YouTube channel. There is a comment section. You can give your comments there also.